Folks, welcome back. I have your latest home prices and insights for York Region. My name is Santo Sessa with RE/MAX Premier. Sales are up across the board. Okay, so we have a slight change in how I'm presenting the York Region data. I'm going to include Vaughan, Richmond Hill, and Markham. So we're going all the major cities across the top, across the top the City of Toronto, so the bottom end of York Region. Condos, though, instead of breaking it up per region when there's only, say, 10 or 11 sales in Vaughan, 10 or 11 sales in Richmond Hill, and similar to Markham, it doesn't make sense to have a weekly report when there's just few sales. I'm gonna summarize condos for all of York Region. So we're gonna start with that. So here's all of York Region, all the condo activity. And sales for the last couple of weeks have been going down, but last week sales went up and the amount of condos selling for $1 million or more went to 3 from 1 last week. When we look at the average sold price, across York Region, the average sold price for condos is $664,000. When we kind of take a step back and try to figure out, well, which way our price is going, it's pretty clear what's been happening with prices in York Region here. When before Christmas, we were kind of sitting and we look at this pile over here, high 500s, very low 600s. And now we're sitting to mid six to up to, 667, 664, 665. So prices have been clearly for condo prices going up in York Region. Now we're going to get into the detached properties and I changed the slides around. I'm confusing myself here. We're going to stick with condos and talk a little bit more about condos compared to where we were last year. Now remember, last year at this time, we're coming out of the crazy health crisis and we're just trying to get our bearings as to what we need to do for the first time with masks. What can we do? What can't we do? And a lot of people are confused, but compared to last year, we're sitting at about 19% higher than we were last year's average sold price. Looking at the sales at the 67, 54% of those sold at list price or more. So more than half. There's some competition with some of the condos being sold, not a ton of competition, although the market is very tight. Listings are up now. Listings generally have been coming down across York Region, and that really, really was making it very tight. Not a lot of choices out there, but last week we listed 134 condos in York Region. And that brings months of inventory to 1. Now, I don't have, like you've seen some of the charts, the other months of inventory. When I start presenting a new chart or a new region to you, I can't go back and get an accurate count of months of inventory just because it's a very fluid, it's a very exact number. And we need to look at how many properties are available for sale right at the end of the period. And as you go back, there's just no way to properly calculate that number. We could look at the months of inventory as per the Toronto Real Estate Board's Market Watch, but those are broken down on a monthly basis. I'm breaking it down here on a weekly basis. So as we go on each week, you're going to see this each week populate here, the months of inventory. But for last week, week ending June 2nd, we're setting out 1 month of inventory. So it's a very tight market. It's a very much a seller's market when it comes to condos in the York Region area. Okay, so now we're going to talk about detached properties. I'm going to start with Vaughan, but I'm also going to talk about Richmond Hill and Markham. So when we look at Vaughan, sales are up. Now, sales have been pretty low for a few weeks there. Now they've jumped up to 69 sales for last week, and the amount of detached property selling at $2 million or more is also up. We went from 8 to 14, close to double there. And average sold price came down a little bit to $1,684,000. So it costs close to $1.7 million for the average detached home in the Vaughan area. And when we kind of look back and say, okay, well, where, what's the trend? What's happening with prices? Well, it's pretty clear to see that from last year, October, November, average sold price has come up. But there's also, you could see that, you know, it went up, it kind of peaked in March, and it's been gradually, very little, coming down a little bit. It's almost flat, but a little bit on the lower side over the April and May, and now we're heading into June. So it's going to be really interesting to see what happens with this price. Is it going to continue to kind of trend down? Now it's just a very, very slight, or is it going to be turning around and going up? And you know, as we head into warmer months, July and August are traditionally a little bit calmer when it comes to real estate, but who knows what's going on with this whole, now that we're kind of getting rid of this whole, that we're coming out of our stay at home, now we could be looking at change things here. Okay, so compared to last year, we're sitting at 23% higher than last year's average sold price. Last year at this time, only two properties sold at $2 million or more. This week was 14, so you know that's got to factor in a big way to the average sold price. Getting back to the sales, of the 69, 58% sold at list price or more. And for the last few weeks, we've been in the low 50%. 58% is an improvement. It's getting tighter out there, a little bit more competition. Listings, though, have been coming down. So sales up, listings are down. That's got to make for a tighter market. And months of inventory now has dropped to 1.1. For a little bit of a while there, it looked like months of inventory were coming up, and that helps to explain why price has kind of been creeping down a little bit, but we're back down to 1.1 months of inventory. Looking at Richmond Hill, sales almost doubled from the previous week. We sold 50 detached properties in Richmond Hill last week. 13 of those sold at $2 million or more. Average sold price has shot way up, $1,857,000 for the average detached property sold in Richmond Hill. And similar to Vaughan, average sold price from last year has gone up, and it looks like it was creeping down for a little bit, but these last couple of weeks here, it's tough to say what direction we're going. Compared to last year, for this week, we're at 14% higher. The last couple of weeks, we're 22% higher than last year's average sold price. Of the 50 sales, 46% sold at list price or more. There's not too many market types or market segments where we're selling less, where it's under 50% being sold at list price or more. Here we're sitting at 46. So let's see what happens in the next few weeks if that loosens up a little bit. Listings are up slightly. 94 detached properties were listed in Richmond Hill, so that should help with some more choices. And months of inventory, it looked like it was going way up, and now it's down again to 1.7. So the listings help it not to come down further, but you know, average sold price is going way up there. And now we have Markham. Now I've been using these charts. My fear is that I take way too long and talk about too many areas, and I just don't want to take up way too long on this presentation, but I thought it's about time I introduce Markham. And sales for the last several weeks have been going up. We sold 76 detached properties in Markham last week. 15 of those have sold at $2 million or more. An average sold price is just under 1.7. $1,693,000 is the average sold price for a detached property in Markham these days. And when we kind of look back at the trend, now Markham, when comparing to Vaughan and Richmond Hill, Markham is pretty clear what's been happening here. From where we were last year, at the end of last year, October, November, average sold price has been going up, and it looks like it went up real quick or real steep to March, and it's still going up slightly. Where Vaughan, it was slightly coming down. For Markham, it's slightly been going up since March. So very strong, strong numbers there in Markham. We are 28% higher than we were last year at this time. Now, we only sold one $2 million property or more last year. This year was 15. That has a lot to do with why average sold price is so much higher. of the 76 detached properties sold in Markham, 59% sold at list price or more. Listings have been coming down each week. We listed only 88 detached properties in Markham last week. Months of inventory is sitting at 0.7. So we have less than 1 month of inventory in Markham. Prices are probably going to continue to go up if months of inventory stay this low. Here's a quick summary. Here's the York Region condo sitting at 1 month of inventory. And for detached Vaughan, Richmond Hill, and Markham, these are the months of inventory. 1.1, 1.7, and 0.7. That's the York Region report. More comprehensive than before. Covers the major cities in York Region and all the condos. Look, if you like what you're seeing here, subscribe below, hit the bell button. It helps us to spread the word of the numbers that are out there. They're real numbers in real estate. My name is Santo Sessa. I'm a full-time realtor with RE/MAX Premier. Have a great day.